If any of you out there play Rainbow Six Siege, then you'll see on the front menu of the game that they've launched a new addition to Rainbow Six Siege called Operation Health. Now, there are good and bad things about Operation Health. Now, the worst thing about Operation Health is that the newest DLC, Hong Kong, will not be released for another 2.5 months. Instead of being released at the start of this month, it's now going to be released in August, so we're not going to get any new content for another 2.5 months. In February, we received the Velvet DLC, which gave us Mirror and Jackal, and a new map, along with new guns. Now, instead of Season 2 giving us the Hong Kong Operators, Season 2 now has been overwritten by Operation Health. Season 3 is when we're going to get the Hong Kong Operators. Now, with Season 3 and the Hong Kong Operators, we're also going to get a Grom Operator. And for Season 4, which starts in November with the Korean DLC, we're getting the second Grom Operator. Now, let me explain a bit about what Operation Health is about. Now, on screen, you'll see Operation Health 3 pillars. The first pillar is technical improvements. The second is the new deployment process. The third is bug fix sprints. They're planning on adding one-step matchmaking along with faster servers, which is very much well needed, as well as higher tick rate and improved hit registration in smaller batches to keep an eye on efficiency. I'll have on screen as well a comparison from the old and the new roadmap so you guys can get a feel, so you guys can see for yourself the major differences. Poland no longer has a dedicated season, and the Grom Operators are going to be released at the start of Season 3 and 4. So instead of getting two Operators in Season 3 and 4, we're going to get three, which still doesn't make up for the fact that we have nothing new in the game until August. I really think they should have launched Operation Health after they released Hong Kong Operators, just to keep the players happy for a few months. I'm not saying that we're getting zero new content, we're getting bug fixes, and also going to improve matchmaking, but I really think that the way they've done this isn't really the best. Thank you guys so much for watching this amazing informational video, and I'll see you in the next.